Hello, my name is João Teixeira and I'm a PhD student in spatial planning at the University of Porto, Portugal. My PhD is focused on bike-sharing systems, and in this presentation, I'm going to specially focus on their potential role during disruptive public health events such as the present coronavirus pandemic. As we all know, coronavirus has severely impacted mobility, reducing travel demand across the world. Public transport systems have been particularly affected due to infection risks and fears. In contrast, use of the private car has been much less affected, leading to a risk of a modal shift from public transport to the private car. Such increase in the use of the private car will most likely jeopardize our current decarbonization efforts of the transport sector, as most CO2 emissions in this sector are from car travel. As such, we need to consider alternative modes to the private car and, as long as the coronavirus remains a threat, also to public transport. A possible alternative could be bike-sharing systems. Among the major strengths of these systems, I will highlight their ability to increase the number and diversity of cyclists, their potential to foster synergies with public transport, including by alleviating some of the pressure from overcrowded systems, and being overall a competitive transport alternative capable of reducing car use. Bike sharing becomes particularly attractive within the COVID-19 context, characterized by geographical limitations on travel, where short trips at local level have gained a new relevance on which the bicycle is especially competitive. As such, it is vital to investigate how bike-sharing systems are performing during this pandemic, not only to design systems better prepared to these types of disruptive events, but also to gain insights on the potential contribution of bike-sharing towards increasing the resilience of our urban transport systems. Therefore, this study had two main research questions. Firstly, how has COVID-19 affected the mobility patterns of bike-sharing users? Secondly, if and how has COVID-19 changed the perceptions and motivations for using bike-sharing? As case study, we used the bike-sharing system of Lisbon, in Tâmega, because it is by far the biggest system in operation in Portugal. Lisbon, like the rest of the country, is heavily reliant on car use, with 45% of all commuting trips being conducted by car, where cycling represents less than 1% of the modal share. To try to tackle this over-reliance on car use, the municipality has started to promote cycling as a mode of transport, including by implementing this bike-sharing system. As our main data collection instrument, we used the travel behavior survey, which was implemented online and disseminated through the social media and mailing lists. It was available between September and October 2020, and we obtained 215 valid answers. In order to assess the impact of COVID-19 on Gira users, we started by classifying our respondents according to their current relationship with the system, dividing them into three major groups. Group A, constituted by the respondents who were users of Gira before COVID-19 and continued to use the system during the pandemic. Then we have Group B, constituted by the users who have joined Gira during COVID-19. And lastly, Group C, constituted by those who have stopped using the system due to the pandemic. With this classification, we then divided the answers of our respondents into two distinct periods of analysis. We have the period before COVID-19, constituted by the answers to the retrospective questions that we have made to groups A and C, and then we have the period during COVID-19, constituted by the answers to the current situation of groups A and B. We start our analysis by looking at the usage patterns of our different subgroups of Gira users, which we can see in this graph. We can observe that about 35% of our respondents have decreased or stopped using Gira as a consequence of COVID-19, but we also see that around 30% have actually increased or joined Gira during this period. The remaining 35% seem not to be particularly affected by the pandemic. We have also asked our respondents to justify the changes in behavior. And so, regarding our new users, 69% of them have stated that their main reason for joining Gira was the consequences of COVID-19. Regarding users who have decreased or stopped using the system, most of them justify their decision on the fact that their trip purpose no longer exists, with only a small minority justifying that they have stopped using the Jira due to the risk of infection. Next, we looked at the main modes of transport in commuting trips of our respondents, which are represented in this graph. In blue, we have the period before COVID-19, and in red, we have the period during COVID-19. And you can see that before COVID-19, the most used mode was public transport, followed by Jira and walking. However, now, during COVID-19, both Jira and walking have surpassed public transport. In fact, Jira is now the most used mode of transport in commuting trips by our respondents. Another aspect that could have been potentially affected by the pandemic is the multimodality nature of Jira's trips. In this graph, we can see the percentage of trips that were conducted in combination with other modes or were single trips. And we can see that before COVID-19, about 67% of all Jira trips were conducted in combination with other modes. However, now during COVID-19, that percentage has declined to 59%, mostly due to a decrease on the use of the public transport in combination with Jira. Although public transport continues to be the most common mode combined with Jira, its share is now much closer to walking. We were also able to analyze the model shift dynamics of Jira by asking respondents which mode of transport they will use if Jira was not available to them in both periods. And you can see that before COVID-19, by far, the most replaced mode was public transport, with 49% of all users stating that they will use public transport if Jira was not available to them, followed by walking and the private car. Interestingly, during COVID-19, even though public transport continues to be the most replaced mode, its share has actually decreased, whereas modal shift has increased in virtually all other modes, particularly walking and the private car. To better understand these new modal shift dynamics, we have developed a Sakai diagram with the answers of the subgroup of users we used Jira before and during COVID-19, because they allow us to directly compare the modes replaced in both periods. And so, in this graph, we have in our left the modes replaced by Jira before COVID-19, in our right the modes replaced during COVID-19. The lines represent the direct shift between the two periods. The thicker the line, the bigger the shift. And we can see that even though most of our users state they would replace the same mode in both periods, around 21% have shifted from replacing public transport to replacing other modes, particularly walking, the private car and personal bicycle. As such, we hypothesize that for some of our users, they no longer consider public transport as a viable transport alternative due to infection risks and fears, and as such, they will use different modes of transport if Jira was not available to them. In the next slides, we will look at motivations and risk perception of using Jira and other modes that will shed some light in this supposition. Starting with motivations, we ask our respondents to classify the importance of several factors on their decision to use Jira through a 5-point Likert scale. Here we focused on those factors that could have been potentially more affected by the pandemic. And we can see some changes between the two periods. First of all, the importance of using Jira to maintain a social distance during the trip has increased significantly in importance. Now, 44% of our users consider this motivation as very important, while before the pandemic, only 11% had this opinion. Furthermore, we also see changes in the motivations related to public transport. First, the importance of using Jira to access public transport has declined. And secondly, and more importantly, the importance of using Jira to avoid public transport has increased significantly. Now, 56% of our users consider this motivation as very important, while before, only 29% had this opinion. Lastly, we looked at the safety perceptions of using different modes of transport in Lisbon before and during COVID-19. And here we can see some changes, particularly regarding public transport. Well, before the pandemic, 74% of all our respondents consider public transport to be safe or very safe, in line, for instance, with safety perception of using the private car. Now that percentage is only 16%. Can also see, in a much smaller scale, a decrease in safety perception of walking or using Shira. In conclusion, our study shows evidence that bike sharing can act as a substitute to public transport during a pandemic such as COVID-19, and several findings support this hypothesis. First of all, we found an increase in the modal share of Shira comparatively to a decrease in the modal share of public transport regarding the main modes of transport in commuting trips. Furthermore, we witnessed an increase in the percentage of Shira single trips, while trips in combination with public transport have decreased. At the same time, now the motivations for using Shira as an alternative to public transport and for maintaining a social distance in the trip have increased in importance. And lastly, there has been a major decrease in the safety perception of using public transport, and while there has also been a decrease in the safety perception of using Shira, that decrease was much lower comparatively to public transport. Furthermore, we also found evidence that bike sharing can ameliorate a surge in car use by preventing some users from shifting from public transport to the private car. So while before COVID-19, around 13% of our users shifted from private car, now that number has climbed to 17%. Furthermore, 10% of our users who before COVID-19 will use public transport if it was not available to them, now will use the private car instead. Therefore, our research provides support on the importance of bike sharing systems to the resilience of urban transport systems during disruptive public health crises such as COVID-19, as bike sharing have the capability to act as a transport alternative to public transport that is perceived to be capable of preserving a physical distance. In that sense, policymakers should consider in their reopening strategies bike sharing, namely by deploying additional bike sharing stations near major trip generators in order to reduce some of the pressure from public transport services. Still, the risk of infection of using bike sharing has increased, with some users quitting the system due to infection fears. In that sense, operators should increase and enhance cleaning procedures, as well as reducing the contact between bike sharing users, particularly at the bike sharing stations, and also publicize those efforts. Even though there is a risk of infection of using a shared bicycle, that risk should be much lower comparatively to enclosed and often overcrowded public transport vehicles, where using a shared bicycle in most of the trip, the user will be able to maintain a physical distance. Thank you for your attention.